everyone, this is Charu, legal intern at Lexis and Company. This video is about the role of customs in Hindu laws. Before getting into the topic, let's first know what are Hindu laws and customs. Hindu law is the rules made for the peaceful existence of the people in the society. Hindu law has been considered as one of the oldest forms of law. It has been derived from the word Sindhu, which is a designation for Indus River. Hindu law is believed to be derived from God himself, or they are considered to be the words of God, revelation by the God himself, and so it is very divine. Hindu laws are codified by the Dharma Shastra writers. Hindu law governs Hindus in their many social aspects such as marriage, divorce, adoption, minority and guardianship, inheritance and other family matters. Coming to customs, customs can be considered as the principal source for the development of Hindu law. Custom in common parlance is an act or behavior which is repetitive or is traditionally accepted, or can also be defined as a habitual practice that a person is uniformly following for a long time. It can also be termed as a rule of conduct. Section 3 of the Hindu Marriage Act in the year 1955 defines custom as a rule which is followed for a long time and has obtained the force of law among people of the Hindu community. It also stated that custom can be ancient, must be reasonable, and it should not be in derogation to the laws of the country. So now let's see the types of customs that shaped Hindu law, that are mainly of four types. They are local customs, general customs, family customs, class or caste custom. Coming to local custom, these are the customs or practices that are binding on people belonging to the Hindu community or a particular geographical area, thus the major part of that particular place culture. Next, the general custom is the customs or practices that prevail in the country as a whole. For example, Indian customs and traditions are the major attraction for tourists. Some of them are the Namaste, which is used to greet people, Tilak, a ritual remark which is a sign of blessings or auspiciousness. Next, the third type is family custom. Family custom can be defined as family tradition or family culture which they are following from a long time, which was given by their ancestors long back. It can also be stated as the environment in which a person is born and brought up by their parents and ancestors. The fourth type is class or caste custom. These are the customs for a particular caste or sectors or class of people such as traders, agricultures, business, etc. Every caste or class has different traditions to be followed, which they have been following for a long time, which can be named as class or caste custom. Judicial notice of a custom. If a custom is established so well and is very much evident, to which a court takes a judicial notice of it and which has repeatedly brought to notice of the court through various cases, such customs are needed to be proven, rather should be established and accepted by the court without any proof. It is not necessary to be proved in each individual case through various acts or conducts, and also the burden of proof lies upon one. Such customs are held to be a part of general law. Some customs and usages are used to codify under Hindu law. With the codification of Hindu law, many customs were abolished, such as the sati system. The sati system, which was earlier followed by the Hindus, in which a widow sacrifices by sitting on the top of deceased husband's funeral. Earlier, women were not given preferences for succession. With the codification of Hindu law, it brought into picture the Hindu Succession Act in the year of 1956. It has given equal treatment to sons and daughters as in matters of succession. Narad Smriti considered customs to be very powerful. Codified Hindu law has given an important place to the custom and usages, and considered it as a parent of Hindu law, it should be limited to certain extent, as the custom have to be expressly proved or brought into the notice to establish it as law. Custom under Hindu Marriage Act in the year 1955 has been used in three situations. Firstly, the marriage can be solicited as per the customary traditions, which is followed by the party. Secondly, divorce can be obtained by practices on the prevailing custom and usages. Thirdly, adoption can be done as per the customary rules. Hindu law is a law which is considered to be of divine nature, as it is believed that it has been developed on the words of God, theories given by God. It is one of the most ancient laws and was written by various rishis. There are various sources of Hindu laws. Sources of Hindu laws are divided into like two categories, namely ancient sources and modern sources. Ancient sources of Hindu laws include Shruti, Smriti, commentaries, digests and customs and usages. Modern sources include judgments and precedents, legislation, justice, equity and good conscience. Among the various ancient sources of Hindu law, custom and usages are regarded as one of the most important sources of Hindu's law. They are considered as a parent of Hindu law. Custom and usages have thus played a major role in developing Hindu law. So that's it for today's video, guys. Don't forget to like this video, comment your thoughts and feedbacks, and subscribe to LexClick for more legal stuff.